Hello friends, myself Chirag. In this video, I am going to discuss about the network edge, topic of computer network. Let us check the outline of this video, what I have covered in this video. First one is what is end system in network. Second one is categories of host. Third one is client server architecture. In this point, I have covered how client and server will communicate with each other. The fourth one is pros and cons of client-server architecture. So let us start with the first point. What is end system in network? We all know that the last device which is connected with the network is called end system. In computer network, computer is the end system. So computers connected with the network are known as end system in the network. Now see one figure. So this is one figure. These are the last devices, two PCs, one laptop and one servers. So that is called the end systems. That all end systems connected with each other through the intermediate devices. Here intermediate devices are router, switch or hub. Now see the example of the different end systems in the network. First one is workstation, PCs and laptop, which is already shown in this figure. The next one is TVs and setup box. Next one is CCTV cameras, household applications, and the last one is popular mobile phones. Mobile phones act as the end system as well as the intermediate devices because we provide hotspot to the another mobile phones or laptops. So mobile phones are end system as well as intermediate devices. Here in computer network, end system is also known as host. Here PC and laptops and servers are also called as host. Next, categories of host. Host can be further divided into two categories. First one is server and second one is client. See in this figure, these three are the end systems, two are the clients and one is the server. So these three are also called as host. Next, client server architecture. So this is the client, or we can say this is the one of the end system in the network. This is server. Server is also an end system in the network. The definition of client is the individual workstation. We can say it may be PC or it may be laptop is called client. So what is server? Server is a centralized computer which is more powerful than client because all the execution of the process will be done at the server side. Client will only access the services from the server. Here, for the security purpose, authentication is required. So no one accesses the server without authentication. So types of server, file server, database server, printer server, email server, and many more. So how exactly client and server will work with each other? Now see in this figure, client will send a request to the server to access the services from the server. Server will try to provide the services to the client. So now you can see over here, after request from the client, server will fulfill this request with the response to the client. So how actually client and server will works with each other? I will give you one example. For example, any user want to access a Facebook server from the anywhere in the world. So user will try to access the FB server. So first of all, user will write facebook.com and try to access the login page. So there is one request will be sent from client to the server. Server will provide a response and open the Facebook login page to the client side. So this is the one of the client server architecture scenario. Next, the software run at the client machine is called a client program. For example, it may be a browser. Next, the software run at the server machine is called a server program. For example, XAMPP, file server or many more softwares are there. Next, pros and cons of the client server architecture. First one, high security. The server is the centralized, so anyone want to access a server from the client machine, so authentication is required. So it is the high security. Next, high performance. The server machine is more powerful than client because all the process will be executed at the server side. Next, centralized backup. So all the data stored at the centralized server, so client can access the data from the anywhere. Next, scalability. Here in client server architecture scenario, it is scalable, because whenever you want to add the number of client machine, no need to restart or no need to shut down the server, or you can remove the number of clients from this client server architecture. So client server architecture is a scalable. Next, to maintain and establish client server architecture, professional network admin is required. Second one, server cost is very high because all the process will be executed at the server side and all the data will be stored at the server side. So cost of that machine is very high. Third one, continuously backup is required. Here all the data will be stored at the centralized server. If centralized server is down, so user will lost all the data. So continuously backup is required of the centralized server.